Mario Bozzoni, After Sales Manager per la divisione Faristo, and I represent the meeting, the seminar. First of all, I apologize for my English. I'm the only one in this group, a large group that is not mother tongue in the English, so I will do. I cannot be so brilliant as Nicky has been before speaking. So, I beg your pardon for all my mistakes in pronunciation. It is very bad also, according to my sons. And mistakes for words missing and grammar. So, I try. I would like to spend two words, a couple of words about Ariston, because probably many of you don't know Ariston. It is our group to which we belong. Is one of the most important actors in the market of painting. Is divided in three different sectors. The most important, representing 90% of the activity, is the thermal comfort, so especially domestic application, with several brands like Ariston, Elco, Chateau, Attack, for example, producing water heaters, oral boilers, boilers, heat pump, solar, and so on. There is a division of components that represent the 4%, mainly produce components for internal use, like thermostat, resistor, also PCB that we are using in some burners. And our burner division, the red one, 6% of activity, everything related to burners. Result of Ariston 2018, 1.6 billion euros, so 2.8 billion dollars. Sales, 8 million products, finished product produced, 6,800 employees, 86 million invested in R&D. Now the situation is actually better. Every year Ariston purchases a new company to enlarge its activity. The last one, important last one, is a Mexican company with more than 100,000 100 million euro, sorry, of turnover. So actually in terms of dollar, the group is at the level of 3 billion to 3 billion dollars, turnover over 7,000 employees. It's an Italian company, managing the owner are Italian, but it's a company that works worldwide, has production sites in 15 countries, has direct offices in 40 countries, and represented 150 countries, so operates in the whole world. Our burner division is 6% of the turnover. Milestone of our history. You see many brands, Elco, Benoit, Ecofarm, SPM, Visia, different companies, different brands purchased by Ariston in the 1899, born a Quenot in Geneva, in Switzerland, and in 1921 produced this first burner. Elco born in 1928 in Switzerland, is a Swiss common of origin. This is important for Knox, so they will explain later. 1929 has been founded Oerkli. Oerkli is not in our group, but from Oerkli born SPM, that is in our group, so the experience of Oerkli in our group. 1973 Ecofarm has been founded in Italy. And then the purchase of the group. In 2001, the group purchased Elco, Quenot together with Chateau and Rendamax. In 2005, Ecofarm. In 2009, born SPM, the spin-off of Oerkli, dedicated, focused on ultra low NOx application up to 1 megawatt. In 2015, the group took the 70% of PM to conclude the 100% this year. And, 2018, BCE has been purchased by the group, is the company for large industrial, really industrial burner for refineries, incinerators, so nothing is in common with the standard. This is our history. Our result, to give you a dimension, 125 million euros to cover last year, 115,000 burners, and you see all our activity in the world of the burner. 81% of turnover is done with burners, accessories, gas train for example, spare parts and service, but we have private service just in the Netherlands and in Germany. Application, Even if the industrial segment is increasing, you can see heating, residential and commercial means the most important activity. So the burner we are delivering in cooperation with fiber belong to this activity, and this red line is the most important for us. A short overview of our burners. ELCO is the widest range, covering from 11 kilowatt to 80 megawatt of burner of power, so it's a very wide range. In addition, we have Quero, ECO, Flame, SPM. We have factories, the burner division in Italy, two factories close to Venice, Oresane and Baselenie. We have a factory in Alsace in France, the factory of SPM, and we have a factory in Germany, in Pirna, where we produce the ECO burners over to Venice. So, looking at the environment, why we speak about NOx. We speak about the NOx because it's a strong problem everywhere, the pollution due to NOx. The NOx, is a result of a chemical combination between nitrogen and oxygen, both participating in the flame, included in the air, 80% of nitrogen, 20% of oxygen. These two elements at high temperature, actually over 1000 degrees, combine themselves, produce NO and NO2. So the NOx, NOx generally indicates everything. There is an important, a strong interest in the reduction of NOx because they are responsible for edge drains and forest destroyed by these edge drains in Europe, are responsible for the smog, for the air, and are responsible for many pulmonary respiratory diseases, like asthma. So there is a strong effect. And our R&D is fully involved as a priority to develop more and more low NOx burner with the goal to reduce the emission and to maintain the simplicity of the standard burner, the ability of the standard burner, and also not increase the cost of it. Very strange. So our goal is make standard a new product that perform better in terms of emission. This is our stronger engagement. ERP directive is an European directive, so nothing requested in New Zealand, but is a top class of the performance. ERP directive, and also the importance of NOx, is a directive finalized to improve efficiency, energy-related products. So, shouldn't speak and request anything about NOx. Should speak and request just the increase of efficiency, the reduction of the consumption of fuel, and in the presentation of follow by fiber, you will see the evolution of the efficiency starting from the old products to the new one. But from the other side, there is a strong interest of Europe to reduce NOx. The normal solution should be, I create a new directive, but this takes time. This takes 8-10 years to have a new directive to reduce NOx. So, the trick has been agreed by everybody to introduce the limit of NOx in a directive of energy saving. Because this directive is already operating, so to accelerate, to speed up the limitation of NOx, because it's really a big issue in Europe and in the world, a directive for energy saving introduces a limitation in NOx in force from September 2018. So this directive fixes for Europe a new range of products less polluting. There is a really strange, I give you an example of the importance of NOx. What happened 3 years ago in China? You know, China, situation of pollution. They burn coal, there are no, everybody knows or they feel like there are no interest at the life of the people. Produce. So they arrive in a status in which in Beijing was impossible. You saw people with the mask moving in the town with the mask. But they told me, during the winter, many times the flies were not able to land in Beijing because there was no visibility. So dramatic situation. They decided rapidly to fix a limit of NOx of 30 milligrams, means three times less the European limit we have. They decided immediately because they need to survive. So they decided to reduce NOx, they reduced it strongly. Okay, it has been also for us because we had a solution to fulfill 30 milligrams and our turnover exploded in China. So it has been very good for us, passed from 6 million to 40 million euros of turnover in 3 years due to the fact that our burner were performing this limit. But imagine China, that in common opinion, doesn't take care of the health, decided to fix a limit three times less than you. So, this is the image of the burner. I explained, I told you before, we have a strong origin in Switzerland, Elco, for instance, Queno, Switzerland, SPM, as it's been offered for 30 years. Switzerland has a long history of open solution. Switzerland in 1992 introduced a regulation for gasoil, the limit is 120 milligrams per cubic meter, less than 3%. This has been introduced 27 years ago. Now ERP asks 120 milligrams, it seems the same, but in milligram per kilowatt hour calculated in another way. Okay, if I transpose this value in the measure of Switzerland, means 127. So the actual limit of last year in Europe for boilers, for heating application up to 400 kilowatts, is less severe than the limit Switzerland introduced in 2017. We have an origin, strong origin, Swiss origin, so 27 years ago we are able to do better. For us it's not a problem to develop a solution. So to give you the confidence that we are able to do it in a reliable way. So, based on our experience, Elco developed a low NOx blue flame solution that is suitable both for kerosene, as used in the UK and Ireland, and for gasoil, as used in the UK and Ireland. This is a picture of a combustion end. What does this solution? Creates a recirculation of flue gas in this area, gasifying the oil from the nozzle, creating so a flame burning the gas oil at the status of gas, so this means the flame. And thanks to this recirculation and better distribution of the temperature, a stronger reduction of the NOx. So we can fulfill 120 milligrams of NOx, while the previous burner, the standard burner that are used in the market without the solution are 220, 250, so the double of emission rate. This picture shows you how the combustion head is done, the same you saw on the table, that you saw on the table, is a patented solution for sure, is a blue technology with a very short combustion head, a very short flame, because the boiler you can see is fantastic for performance, you will see the efficiency, but especially for dimension. It's a very compact burner. The combustion chamber is short. We need a short combustion and a very short flame. This solution performs both solutions. Easy application for fixed head approach is our presenting the factory. We don't ask you to adjust the position of the disc inside this cone because it's done by us, the factory. Possibility to work with a CO2 spread from 10.5 to 13.5, sometimes 14%, so a very large spread. In this spread of CO2, we guarantee the performance of the burner. I will show you a picture of the performance. We adjust the burner at 12.5% of CO2, against the 11.5 more or less of the previous burners, not Ronox, not a blue flame. So means 1% more of CO2 means a 1% or 1.5% more in efficiency. Very low soot, so very low CO, very low NOx, okay? But nobody sees. NOx and CO don't stay in the boiler, soot remain in the boiler. So the fact to have a clean flame without soot means that at the end of the season, all the boiler will be clean. At least the dust, not the soot. You can put the finger on the boiler inside the combustion chamber and not find the soot. Means maintaining the flue gas temperature stable in all the week, in all the season, maintaining the best performance in terms of efficiency. In addition, excellent cold start, so start of the burn reliable also in the worst condition, and vitiation. Vitiation means, I spoke with some of you, the possibility to burn also in case a bad chimney, a bad wind, force the flue gas to be suctioned from the burner. So the burner that works with the recirculation of flue gas internally. The combustion head is a result of our experience coming from different histories. Last tube used the experience of ELCO with his internal wheeler to make the frame shorter. Disc is exactly the disc we use in Quenor since 30 years ago, maybe. So it's absolutely reliable. This system of disc and electrodes, if you go to the website of Quenor and you look at the burner NC4, we sold more or less 25,000 pieces per year in France, but the same disc you have here, so it's absolutely reliable. And behind the strongest ventilation in the market done by EcoFan. The fan of this burner has a performance fantastic. But let us put this distributor of air to make the distribution homogeneous and to introduce a resistor. The resistance in the air circuit to smooth all the oscillation we have at the normal condition. So to have a very stable in very few milliseconds. For this burner you can see the red line, plafond max 4, the burner is FP4 coming from the plafond max 4, the performance of the fan, 24-25 millibar of pressure. So, I would like to tell you how we developed the project. Don't think that it's a burner from catalog that we agreed with the fiber. Okay, it's good for you, this is the burner, this is the price, this is the quantity, commercial agreement. No, no. We have worked for more than 3 years to develop the burner. So we have a basis, but we tailored the burner on the boiler of fiber. There was a strong collaboration together. And this is a view of our laboratory in which you see 3, 6 and more boilers of fiber on which we did all the tests, the performance to verify the real performance on all the possible potential chimney we can have. You can see all the chimney that can be connected to the burner to verify the all the conditions. 8. Requirement to validate the project to regarding the performance, smoke index, NOx, CO, to regarding the cold start, the worst condition for ignition, one regarding the possibility to work properly without producing too much CO, with the recirculation of the flue gas at least 8%. A check of unburns because it's important to keep the boiler, and finally endurance test. I pass rapidly. For example, the model for 20 kilowatt has the NOx to fulfill completely the standard from 14% to 10.5% of CO2. The same for CO, the red line, the limit of ERP is this one, we stay at this value. So 13.5 we stay at 20 milligrams, 15 ppm or less. And the green is the index, the soot index, the backer, the black soot we measure on the paper of the filter when you do the test, you know, the test of the backer. 0.1, 0.2, 0.1, 0.2. So if you put on the paper in white, we have an electronic measurement that is able to give 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. The standard request 1. So, 0.1, 0.2. Cold start. This is a test of cold start. We record the variation of the pressure to indicate the instability or not. Initial, we adjusted the CO2 not at 12.5 but at 11, 1.5 less. Boiler cold, chimney cold, water cold, air cold, everything cold in this condition. Ignition has been measured in 27 milliseconds, and you see that in a very short time, in very few seconds, the condition has been stabilized. Another test of cold start we do perform putting a resistance in the chimney, simulating a long chimney, very cold, that doesn't have any drop. So we add 0.5 millimeter water column in the resistance in the chimney, and we measure the ignition. So ignition has been running 20 milliseconds, and we have a special instrument to measure the Bacharach, the Union Soot Index, in the first 10 seconds, not in the long term time, but in a short time, because it's the moment of the ignition we produce the soot. And we have three of Bacharach, when a normal yellow flame has 9-10, so it's black if you measure the soot in this phase. The pressure, combustion chamber back pressure, performance of the fan, we can lose 4 millibar in the burn. So we have a residual pressure in the fan that can win every condition stabilized the performance of the burn. Finally, endurance test. We spend so long time to check the performance, to fulfill the standard, to let the firewall homologate the products completely and so on. But we don't want to launch a product if before we don't perform an endurance test in two types of cycle, 2 minutes on, 2 minutes off, 20 minutes on, 5 minutes off. And we need at least 5,000, for example, 500 cycles. After that, we open the boiler, we look at the combustion head, the disc, the part of the boiler, is everything is really clear. And for sure, no fault. So only after all these tests, we are quite ready for the commercialization. We decided with Firebird that we wanted to have another test, field test on the field. So if the year before the commercial launch, we installed 400 units to check one season of heating to be sure that no problem happened. So after this long time of 3 years, we are ready to launch a product that for us is absolutely reliable. Product is Firebird FB4. This label indicates type, Firebird 4, the platform number 4, R to indicate that the nozzle is plated, the oil is plated in the nozzle, 20 is a nominal kilowatt, and LN low NOx. For sure, it's a low NOx, low flame. The burner is equipped by three stickers. One is the label below, before. One is a label indicating the original equipment and the presetting, so the type of the nozzle, the pressure you have to adjust. All data indicated in the manual, but sometimes you have in the manual with you in the back, and the shoulder bag you have on the chair. But many cases the manual be lost, and a sticker is additional information useful for us. Finally, the most important, the sticker put on the back of the cover indicated how to adjust the cover. And we come technical data you find in the manual, description of the components the same, by rapid. Control box is a microprocessor controller that gives 15 seconds of pre-ventilation, 15 seconds of positive. Post-ventilation is a plus, it's not necessary for the burner, is a plus to clean completely the boiler and the chimney and everything starts top of the burner. If you switch off completely, for sure the burner will not give the post-ventilation, but I repeat, it's not good. Performance under voltage, so is the supply go down below 170 volt, the burner stop and restart when the voltage rises up to 190. And the burner can go in lockout for two reasons. One, if the photodetectors see the flame during thermoventilation, so this means the photodetector is faulty, or if the first 5 seconds we don't have the flame, so the flame has not been established. Okay, last point. Right time. I explained our history and our experience from blowouts. I tried to explain it. What is behind the launch of the product? The product for aftertears, believe me, is fantastic. But how to assure you that the, not the project, but the product is fantastic. The product is real, is in production. It's not the idea, it's the project, it's the production. How we can assure you that you receive a completely tested a reliable product, our test in production. Our test in production is a picture of our assembly line. In the assembly line we'll do electrical safety test, requested by the standard. We check the hermeticity of the circuit, because probably it's not the case of New Zealand, but in UK, I've installed it in the kitchen. So if the circuit of air is not tight, there is the risk of gas entering in the room. So we do this test and we check the ventilation. For hermeticity, we ask a leakage maximum of 4 liters per minute under the pressure of 1.5 milliliters. We record the data, because we record the data, and this is the Gaussian summary of the result. The most part of the leakage at 2.5 liters. If we are over 4, the burner is refused. In the same test, as the combustion end is fully closed, we check and we measure the pressure, potential pressure of the fan. If the fan doesn't give at least 22 millibar for the smallest and 25 for the bigger burner, the burner is refused. So this means that his ventilation is not okay. So we do also this. Finally, the burner before the packaging goes in the firing test. All the burners are installed on the related boiler on which they will be installed on the field, with the conventional full system, 1.5 meter long, 18 millimeter diameter. And we pre-adjust the combustion. We adjust the combustion based on the temperature. Usually it's 20 degrees, so if we do the assembly in winter, inside the factory we have 20 degrees, we adjust the CO2 at 12.5%. In this test, all the data recorded, and we have some threshold of acceptance. So, we measure the pressure drop in the combustion end. If it's out of this range, the burner is refused. We measure the electrical consumption. This is out, is refused, because there is a problem in the motor or in the pump. We check the positional flap. Is out of this, is refused, because there is something not correct in the flap. We check, we adjust CO2, the CO2. We measure and record the NOx and the CO2. We do all these tests, this verification, this automatically recorded in our system. If something is wrong, the burner is refused. So we are sure in this way that you receive only burner absolutely tested and performing in all their features for all our complete production. These are information from the manual. It passes rapidly how to install the burner, how to connect the air, how to remove the cover, the pump, how to connect the two flexible burner installation to pipe system, how to calculate the diameter of the pipes for the supply of the oil. The check you have to do before the commission, it is a normal check for every burner, normal for every light oil burner. Adjustment, we ask you to start the burner. Wait stabilization time of at least 15 minutes. If necessary, to adjust the pressure. 11.5, 10.5 or 11.5 bar, in this case, just the pressure. And finally, to adjust the CO2. To adjust the CO2, we're using the flue gas analyzer, and based on the temperature you have in this moment. If you have 20 degrees, exactly as we had in the factory, we adjust 12.5. We don't have to make some big correction because we already adjusted the burner at 12.5, but your chimney is different, your altitude is different, so you have different conditions different from our in the laboratory, so you have the small adjustment to do. If you do the commissioning at minus 5 because it's strong winter, you must adjust 11.5 of CO2. If you do a commissioning at 30 plus 30, you adjust 12.8 of CO2. If you do this, the burner is adjusted perfectly because this variation is the variation of the CO2 during the year based just on the external temperature. The burner follows this line, and the burner can arrive up to 13.5%, 14 sometimes, and down at 10.5. This means it can go here, imagine which temperature, minus 30, and here, imagine which temperature, plus 60. So if you do this, it's the only thing we have to do. If you do this at the commission, the burner is okay. Simple maintenance, we deliver an Allen key 4 mm, which is smart everything, except that the last tube, you need a screwdriver and 2 keys for them. And rapid late pass with these images comes from the manual you already have. We deliver a template fixed on the cable of the burner that is useful to check the distance between the nozzle and the disc, and to check the right position of the nozzle rod versus the blast tube, because I repeat, we work with the disc inside the core. This adjustment is made by us, and the adjustment screw is sealed by silicone. For sure, if someone move, use the template to readjust once again the light position. We don't ask you to set the compressor level, but only to check. And use the same template to check the position of the electrodes. Pump, how to open the burner to clean the fan. Maintenance, normal maintenance for a gasoil burner. Clean the flame sensor, replace the nozzle every year, clean the pump, its filter, check the status of the flexible, the hoses in case replace, and we recommend to replace every 2 years for safety reason. Check the fuel in the tank, remove the water, and every year check the combustion, so CO2, CO, soot index, and temperature. The spare parts can be subjected to Vera, and the nozzle, the gasket, the flexible, this is the usual time that we suggest for the replacement. You have exploded tube of the burner, which you can find on the If you have any question, I'm available, speak only slowly, and I can stay around the burner if at the end of the presentation you want to check manually something. Thank you for attention and sorry for me.